Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is a video talking about the different Islamic sects in Islam and the different groups that formed, and just kind of a quick history of basically talking about them and Ahmadi's relationships, in fact, in this branch. Now, in the very beginning, you only had one group of Muslims, and that was the Orthodox Muslims, and they were guided by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There was no such thing as even an Orthodox Muslim. Everyone was a Muslim. And there were no prefixes or suffixes or anything needed. Why? Because there really was even no group or branches or anything. And this is, in fact, during the time of the first early generations of the Muslims, for example, of Abu Bakr, of Umar, of Uthman. And then, in fact, during the time of the Khilafah of Ali alayhi salam, something happened in the Muslim Ummah that had never existed before. And that was the emergence of the first sect of Islam. And this was, in fact, called the Khawarij. And, in fact, they still are in existence to this day, although very, very small, and, in fact, they've changed their name. But, in fact, they had the different ideas and different ideologies that were different from the original Muslims. And this sect was the first sect to ever form in the Muslim Ummah. The second, another group that formed was, in fact, the Shia. And the Shia, in fact, split into dozens and dozens, and I really mean dozens, of splinter groups that, in fact, exist to this day, with three main dominant groups. One of them is, in fact, more dominant than all of the other ones combined, but, in fact, they still exist to this day. During this time, also, other groups started to form that had never existed, such as the Mu'tazila, and the Qadariya, and the Jabariya. And all these different groups began basically influenced by outside ideologies, outside beliefs, things of this nature. Now you can see in this graph here, I don't really have anything from probably about 300 to about 1200, but in fact during this time also there were other groups that in fact formed, other new ideologies, other new beliefs, that in fact formed during this time that broke apart from this original group of Muslims dating back from the Prophet ﷺ, the original theology, the original belief, the original understanding of Islam. Now, what's interesting is that if you take any single one of these groups of Muslims, any single one of them, and let's say, for example, one that formed in the year 500, what's really interesting about them is that for all of these groups, there was a time when their religion, their branch of Islam, or the ideas, their beliefs, simply do not exist. So, for example, if we're talking about one that formed in 500, in the year 400 after the Hijrah, they didn't even exist. There was no such thing as that branch of Islam. In the year 300, even more, nobody even thought of their ideas. And so the same thing can be said about every single group here. And the way you know that a group is false is you say, how far did this group trace back? Does it trace back all the way to the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? If so, then it's the original Islam, and it's the Islam that the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, in fact, told us to believe in. And if not, then it's essentially a deviation from the original belief of the Muslims, and it's a new ideology that never existed in the Muslim Ummah. Now, during this time, the Muslims also had to debate with these other ideas and these new ideologies. Why? Well, because they weren't that simple. They weren't simply just misreadings of the Quran, because, you know, everyone could read Arabic, everyone was sophisticated. Rather, in fact, they were sophisticated, well-thought-out, powerful, in fact, sometimes, arguments against this original branch of Islam. So, for example, with the Mu'tazila, which is, in fact, one of the larger branches that broke off, this group over here had differences that were fairly strong against the early group of Muslims. And in fact, the early Muslims, in fact, refuted them in a very strong way, and the debates went back and forth until the Mu'tazila eventually died off and, you know, dwindled over time, and for the most part, they're gone now. But during this time, the Muslims wrote theological works to defend and propagate the original group of Islam against these other deviations that had split from the original group of Muslims. They wrote books, they wrote texts, they wrote articles, they wrote essays. There were all sorts of theological works to discuss and refute these branches that had essentially broken off from the mainstream group of Muslims and had formed their own sects and ideologies. Now let's fast forward, or in fact from this time over here, all the way back to 1,300 years after the demise of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. During this time in rural India, another group formed, which is in fact this video is intended for, which was the Ahmadi, or Ahmadiyya, or the Ahmadi branch. And in fact, this branch, or this sect, or whatever you want to call it, essentially has new ideas, new beliefs, that were simply not part of this mainstream group of Muslims. And in fact, they believe they have their five khulafa, as they call them, their supreme spiritual leaders, and all their different ideas and concepts that they have, in fact. And they say, what one of their claims, is that they are, in fact, a revivalist movement. They are, in fact, bringing Islam back to this period. And what they're going to say is that the Muslims over here, right, that have remained on the same consistent Islam for all this time are, in fact, not following the traditional Islam, not following the original Islam, and, in fact, are basically a stray group. And they are, in fact, the group that's upon the truth. Now, that's a pretty bold claim, and obviously one that has many arguments on their side, and in fact, arguments back and forth. Now, without getting into the arguments, which I've in fact done in many, many, many other videos, I want to one basically posit one challenge to my Ahmadi viewers. If you believe that this branch of Islam, if this offshoot group is in fact the true Islam, is in fact the original Islam, the Renaissance, as I often hear, is in fact bringing Islam back all the way back to this period, then what it should do, in theory, is that its beliefs should conform to the beliefs of the Muslims from every successive generation. From the Muslims from this period to the Muslims from this period to all the way through, their beliefs, the Ahmadi beliefs, should in fact conform to this original branch of Islam. Whenever you want to say that the original deviation from the Muslims occurred, let's say you say it occurred, I don't know, 1,000 in the year 1,000 after the death of the Prophet, then it should conform to the beliefs from 900 years before then, or 700, or 600, or 500, or so on and so forth. That your belief should conform to a period, basically during that time when Islam was in fact pure. That's what your religion should in fact do. Now, one of the things that I'm going to say as an Orthodox Muslim, as a Muslim essentially over here, is that I'm going to say that my beliefs, in fact, conform to the original Islam of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. Now, how am I going to posit this belief? I'm going to say that every group of Muslims, essentially when they wrote their theological works during their time on how they interpreted the Quran, how they interpreted the Sunnah, how they understood that, you will see a consistent chain. So what the Muslims believed here is what the same thing that the Muslims believed here, the same thing the Muslims believed here, the same thing here, here, etc., etc. The only difference has perhaps been the way that they expressed the same points, but the points were exactly the same. You will see a consistent chain of beliefs exactly the same all the way down to what the Muslims are in present day, which is 1,431 years after the death of the Prophet ﷺ. However, you will see radical deviations in Ahmadiyyism from the original group of Muslims. You will see radical deviations, beliefs that simply didn't even exist, for example, in the year 800 after the death of the Prophet ﷺ. They are brand new beliefs that simply did not exist during that time and, in fact, were unheard of. Now, like I said, if you want to know whether or not a group is the true group of Muslims, simply take it back, and if you can ever at any point say that this group did not exist, then it could not possibly be the true group of Muslims. Because, for example, the Mu'tazila didn't exist at this point here. They only started to exist here, but they never existed here. Therefore, they couldn't possibly be true. Same thing with the Shia, same thing with the Khawarij. At one point, they simply did not exist. And likewise, I also draw this criteria for the Ahmadis. At one point, their beliefs simply did not exist, and in fact were only invented roughly 100 years ago after the death, which is 1,300 years after the death of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I don't want to leave you guys empty-handed. For those who are a bit more scholarly, who are interested in reading texts and things of that nature, I want to say a couple of things. That there was a text that was written, in fact, around this time that is called Aqidah Tahawiyya. Aqidah Tahawiyya. I've discussed it in many of my other videos, but I want you guys to take a look at that text and see what the Muslims from that period believed and, in fact, how they understood Islam according to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And, in fact, this, like I said, is during the time when other groups were forming, they were, in fact, refuting those other false beliefs. And so this text was written by the original Muslims. The second thing I want to say is that in the book, A Book of Religious Guidance for Ahmadi Muslims, which is, in fact, one of the texts written by the Ahmadis, they, in fact, outlined who they believe are the Mujaddids of the past 14 centuries. And the 14th one is Mirza Ghulam Ahmad. They say the 13 other ones are, in fact, from all of these periods, and, in fact, were the revivers of Islam during these periods. So what I want to say to the Ahmadis is that if you truly believe that your religion is, in a sense, a revivalist movement, then naturally you should be able to look at those lists of mujaddids, those lists of revivers, and you should be able to see that what they wrote, what they posited as their understanding of Islam, which has essentially remained consistent for this entire period, should in fact agree with Ahmadiyya, should in fact agree. And Ahmadiyya should not be the odd one out. And if it is the odd one out, then the problem lies in Ahmadiyya. And with that, I want to close and continue to call all of my Ahmadi viewers to leave the false religion of Ahmadiyya, a religion that was only formed 100 years ago, and to follow the same Islam that has remained consistent for 1,431 years all the way to the present day. وصلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم الله سبحانه وتعالى وهو حسبنا ونعم الوكيل